Sets in mathematics are collections of distinct elements, and we can study membership of an element, union of two sets, intersection, difference, and many other things. And we may want to replicate this model in DSA. We may want to have a data structure that stores elements without duplicates, and on which we can apply operations like union and intersection. This is why today we will learn about the set data structure. Such a structure can be useful in a lot of situations. We're traversing a graph and we want to store visited vertices to avoid cycles, we use a set. We have a string and we want to count the number of its unique characters, we use a set. We want to remove duplicates from an array, we use a set. And we can add many more examples. But how to implement such a structure? First of all, we need to know what will the structure stores and what operations we want to optimize. Our structure will store single elements, like an array does, for example. For operations, we usually have these three main operations: inserting an element, checking if an element belongs to the set, and deleting an element. By the way, insertion shouldn't happen if the element already exists in the set. Remember that a set doesn't contain duplicates. And we can also have operations like the union of two sets, intersection, difference, is subset, etc. A simple implementation would be to use an array. We store elements of our set in an array, and we just make sure to avoid duplicates by checking existence before inserting. Okay, but what time complexity do we get? For insertion, adding an element at the end of an array is an O(1) amortized time. But we first need to check if we don't already have it, which requires traversing the array, O(n) time. For checking membership, we need to perform a linear search, which is an O(n) time. And for deleting, we first need a linear search to locate the element, O(n) time, then removing it and shifting remaining elements, O(n) time. So we get O(n) for the three operations, quite slow. A better implementation that we can use when we want to optimize insertion, check-in membership, and deletion is by using a modified version of the hash table. Yes, let me explain why. But you first need to watch the hash tables video. It's necessary to understand this one. Please watch it before continuing, because you need to understand how does a hash table work, time complexity of its operations, etc. In a hash table, we store key value pairs, which is different from a set where we store single elements. But one important property is that in a hash table, keys are unique, same as elements of a set. This is why we can use a hash table to implement a set and consider the keys of that hash table as the elements of our set. It means that we don't care about the values, we're just interested by the keys. For example, if we want to have a set that contains these elements, we can insert them in a hash table with any value and the set of keys now represents the set we want. We can put anything as the value, it doesn't matter, we can put true or something. We can even make an implementation where we don't even store a value, we just store keys. This is what we will do right now. In our hash table implementation, we use separate chaining. Pairs with the same hash were stored in a linked list. A node of a linked list had the key, the value, and the pointer to the next node in the list. For implementing a set, we don't need the value, we just keep the key and the pointer. Same thing when inserting. When inserting, we needed both the key and the value to make a node. Here we just need the key, so we remove value from all insert operations in the implementation. That's it, that's all we need to change to get rid of the value. Now we got our implementation, but how are operations gonna work? Well, pretty similar to hash tables. We use hashing to find the spot where our key should be, and we traverse nodes of the linked list to check if it's there, or to insert it, or to delete it, depends on the operation. We can even add operations we talked about before: union, intersection, difference, and a subset. Okay, but what about time complexity? Is it better than using an array? Yes, definitely. Inserting in a hash table is an O of 1 amortized time in average, searching is an O of 1 time in average, and deleting is an O of 1 time in average. We've seen why in the previous lecture. We get the same result for our set implementation. The implementation is almost the same. We just remove the value attribute. This is why using a hash table is a very good set implementation. Here is a full example by using our implementation. We perform a bunch of set operations. However, this was just for learning purposes. Depending on the language you use, you don't need to implement a set from scratch as we did. For example, in Python, we have the set type. We can add elements, check in membership, delete, perform union, intersection, difference, etc. It's ready to use. Also, we may want to, in addition to operations we made possible, have elements of our set in a sorted way, which is not the case with our actual implementation, because a hash table doesn't keep elements sorted. If we want to have elements always sorted, then we're dealing with an ordered set, which is implemented differently from an unordered set like in this lecture. We will talk about it in another lecture. Meanwhile, if you enjoy this video and want to support the channel, you can like and subscribe, and check our courses, links are in the description. See you in the next one.